my people, and give heed to me, my nation, for a teaching will go out for me, and my justice for a light to the people. I will bring near my deliverance swiftly. My salvation has gone out, and my arms will rule to the people. The coastlands wait for me, and for my arm they hope. Lift up your eyes to the heavens, and look at the earth beneath. For the heavens will vanish like smoke, the earth will wear out like garment, and those who live on it will die like gnats. But my salvation will be forever, and my deliverance will never be ended. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now when Jesus came into the district of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" And they said, "Some say John the Baptist, but others Elijah, and still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter answered, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." And Jesus answered him, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven. And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven." Then he sternly ordered the disciples not to tell anyone that he was the Messiah. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. It seems so fitting to me. So I got out and wore my Man of La Mancha t-shirt when I was writing this sermon. You see, some years ago, Mary and I were in New York City. We were able to go to the discount ticket booth in Times Square and buy cheap tickets to the Broadway revival of the musical Man of La Mancha. This old musical from the 60s features its main character, Don Quixote, an often delusional fellow who charges and tilts at windmills because he thinks that they are evil giants. But the most famous piece of music from this Broadway show, it just has to be the song, The Impossible Dream. That's been sung by everyone from Frank Sinatra and Elvis Presley to Luther Vandross and Aretha Franklin. But there's one phrase. One phrase in that song I want to lift up for us today. To be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. To be willing to march into hell. I need to tell you today that that's really what Jesus is saying in the gospel reading. Jesus had asked his disciples who other folks thought that he might be, and the other folks had guessed bunch of famous prophets like Elijah, Jeremiah, even John the Baptist back from the dead. Jesus asked them who they thought he was, and Peter responded. Peter blurted out the truth. "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." peacefully revolted. They were liberated from Soviet control and East and West Germany as countries were reunited. Soon the wall was torn down, and the church building had been gone for several years. But the German Lutheran Church decided to build a small chapel at that site, a chapel with the same name as that old church and its congregation. Ironically, the name for that was the Lutheran Church of Reconciliation. You see, walls and gates rise and fall in history, but the good news of Jesus Christ endures. The gates of Hades, the gates of hell, have been closed and held humanity captive to sin and death, but not only did Jesus die and rise again, breaking the grip on us, but Jesus gave that message to us to proclaim and to use to continue to smash down the gates of hell, sin, and death. Yet still, human beings in our flesh, we'd like to build big walls with small gates to keep the right people out. praise you, God, for your word.
We praise you, God, for your word.
Your word is a lamp lighting our path, a mirror reflecting ourselves, a shield providing us refuge, a fire burning for justice and truth. Your word is sweeter than honey and nourishes our bodies like milk and sustains your people like bread. We receive your promises and are treasured in gold. We bless you, O God, for your word.
We bless you, O God, for your word.
Two things coming up in the next 2 weeks I want to alert you to. The first is next Sunday, we will be offering prayers and a small gift to all the students, teachers, support staff, administrators involved in education, whether it be preschool, public school, childcare, universities, people of every age. This is a very stressful and unusual year to resume school. You know that it's, some places it's totally virtual, some places it's in person. There's lots of fear connected to that. That fear is not unfounded, okay? And so we want to make sure that, as we do every year, but especially this year, we offer prayer as a token gift to reminder of Christ's presence with people as they do their daily ministry as learners and educators. Not only do we do that on Sunday, we're going to do that on the following Wednesday. So that would be not this Wednesday, but Wednesday, I think it's the 30th of your bulletin. Is that right? September 7th, sorry, thank you. 30th is Sunday, thank you. Okay, and we're going to do a drive-by after school, okay, which means that we want you to share with your extended family, with friends, okay, people who have children, teachers, could just drive by and give them a prayer card, say a love, a token, for them to take with them. We want to make it all there, okay, so please spread the word. This is an event, basically. Acknowledge that this is an especially difficult school year for everyone, okay? Then two Sundays from now, it's Labor Day weekend, and what our custom has been, we'll continue to do that, is to give thanks for and bless the daily vocations that people have. Sometimes you get paid for that, sometimes you don't. Sometimes it's being a volunteer, sometimes it's just part of your family. You know, it's simply a part of who we are as Christians, that God calls us into a lot of ways of living out our baptismal calling, and we will do that on Labor Day to celebrate the work that you do. Now, I invite you to be able to please stand. Either dead.